Hello, my name is Emily Smith, and I'm a research and instruction librarian here at USCB Library, and today I'm going to show you how to find research articles using the library's website. To get to the library's website from the USCB homepage, you can click on the magnifying glass, type in library, and the first link that comes up will take us to the library's homepage. First, we'll look at the library's catalog. You can start searching the catalog by typing your search terms into the search bar, or you can click on the link to open the catalog and search from there. In order to access the articles from off campus, you will need to log in. Your login username is the first part of your university email address, and the password should be the same as your email password. Now that I'm logged in, I'm going to start my search. My topic is quietness of the hospital environment. So I'm going to go ahead and type that into the search bar. The library catalog searches a variety of resources, including all physical items held by the library, such as books and DVDs, as well as online resources such as journal articles, newspaper and magazine articles, ebooks, and more. In the catalog, we can find both print and online resources. Many of the library's databases are integrated into the library's catalog, so you are able to search the databases and catalog at the same time. Since this is an online class and we may not have access to the physical library, I want to limit my results to resources that are accessible online. On the left side of the page are limiters, and here I can select Available Online. One of the criteria your professor has set is to find literature no more than 5 years old. I can set this by going to creation date and typing in 2016, then clicking refine. I am going to lock these limiters in place by selecting remember all filters. After entering our search terms and setting our limiters, we have over 500 results. Maybe I've browsed through these and I'm just not finding what I'm looking for. How can I change my search to find different or more focused results on the same topic? I'm going to show you how making small changes in your search terms can change your search results. I began my search by typing my topic exactly as it was written on my paper. When searching in the library catalog or databases, we want to do what is called a keyword search. This is taking the important words in my topic and focusing on these words to find relevant search results. Online databases don't take smaller words such as it, the, by, and of into consideration. If I remove of and the from my search, we can see I have the same number of results because these words were not counted in the initial search. By omitting these words, I am left with quietness, hospital, and environment. My first search looked for any occurrence of my keywords in any order in the sources. I want to find quietness of the hospital environment as a phrase where all the words appear in the exact order in which I typed them. To do this, I could put quotation marks around the words. This drops us down from 548 results to 64. We may not see this phrase in the title or the description of the article, but if we look in the article, we will find at least one occurrence of the exact phrase, quietness of the hospital environment. I can change my keywords again by separating quietness from hospital environment. This time I'm going to put quietness by itself and keep hospital environment together in quotation marks. Now I have 126 results to look through. Using and between search terms is called Boolean searching. Putting and between words ensures I will find both words occurring in the article, but not necessarily together. Similarly, I can use or and not as Boolean connectors. Now we can take a closer look at some of our search results. A lot of these articles have a purple peer-reviewed icon. Peer-reviewed articles are articles that have been reviewed by other experts in the field. If I submit an article to a journal, an editor will review my article before publishing. Peer-reviewed articles have undergone an extra step and have also been reviewed by other experts in the field. This adds extra validity and credibility to the article. Here we also see an orange open access icon. This means that the article is freely available to everyone. Articles that are not open access are only available through the USCB Library. Since you are a student at USCB, you have special access to our databases and articles that are not available through open access. You do have to log in to access resources provided by USCB. USCB Library has paid for access to approximately 200 databases, which includes thousands of journals and hundreds of thousands of articles. This cuts out the hassle of searching online and not being able to access the information or finding information that is not reliable or credible. If you have an assignment where you are not allowed to use online resources, this is not referring to the library catalog or databases. This is referring to searching through Google and using information found there. Searching online requires the extra hassle of determining if the website you are using is reliable and credible. USCB Library has eliminated this step for you by providing you resources through our catalog and databases. They are available online for ease of access, but they are not considered online resources. All resources provided by USCB Library are reliable and credible academic resources. Let's take a look at an article. We can see this article is peer-reviewed and open access, so it is freely available to everyone. Click on the title to view the item record. All item records should have these options and information. Under Tools, you can email the article to yourself, scan the QR code, or access the permalink to the article, find a citation for the article, which you can copy and paste into your document, or print the article information. To access the full text article, we need to go to View Online. Here we can see the title of the journal the article was published in, as well as the dates of the journal we have access to. Click on the journal title to open the article in a new tab. This is where we have access to the full text article. This journal offers some features similar to the catalog. There is a citation tool where you can copy and paste the citation into your document, and you can also email this article to yourself. Additionally, you can download this article and save it to your device. I would highly recommend downloading and saving the article. Now let's take a look at an article that is not open access. Click on the link for full text availability to open the article in the database. Click the title of the article, and you will see an item record similar to the record we found in the catalog. There is an abstract or description of what the article is about, the option to email the article to yourself, and citation tools where you can copy and paste the citation into your document. Always double-check the citation to make sure it is correct. For example, this citation has most of the words in the title capitalized, but for a citation, you typically only have the first word of the title capitalized. You will need to make this correction in your citation. One tip for pasting citations into your document, right-click in your document with your mouse and select Merge Formatting. This is the clipboard with the arrow. This will change the format of the citation to the format of your paper, and you don't have to worry about changing the font or trying to get rid of that pesky gray background. You may also want to take a look at subject headings. A subject heading is a word or a phrase used to find and organize information by topic. If I want to find related articles about patient satisfaction, click on the Patient Satisfaction subject heading and it will bring up a list of articles that all have the subject heading Patient Satisfaction. Let's go back and take a closer look at the article. Click on the PDF full text link to read the article. As I scroll through the article, you can see there are section headings. We see words such as purpose, sample selection, and design and methods, which help us know that this is a research article. The key to reading research articles is to start at the beginning and skip to the end. Start by reading the introduction and the purpose, then going to the end of the article and reading the nursing implications and conclusion or discussion. These sections summarize the rest of the article and give you more information to help you decide if this article will work for you. This will help you save time reading and more quickly evaluate the content of an article to determine if this is a good resource for you. From this page, you can also download the article and save it to your device. This way, you can access the article anywhere, anytime, and don't have to log into the library website to access the article. Next, we will take a look at searching individual databases. USCB Library subscribes and pays for access to approximately 200 databases, which are accessible from the library homepage. You can click on Find Journals and Databases and select a subject from the drop-down list, or you can click on the A to Z Databases List link under Quick Links to view a complete list of available databases. Here, our databases are listed in alphabetical order. We can sort them by subject by clicking on the All Subjects drop box. For this class, we want to see the nursing databases. Each database provides a brief description to help you make an informed decision about where to start. The database you use may depend on your topic. Looking at the database description, I'm going to start in CNAW Plus. Click on the title to open the database in a new window. I'm going to start by typing in my topic. And already, I can see I have a lot fewer results than when I searched in the catalog. I need to refine my results by changing the date so I only have articles from the past 5 years. Taking a look at these articles, I see some say check for full text and others say PDF full text. Check for full text means this article is not available in this database, but it may be available in one of our other databases. If you want your results list to only show articles we know for certain we have access to, you can click on Full Text under Refine Results. Looking at this article, I can see it is another research article and is 11 pages long. To start with, I will read the opening section, then scroll down to the end and read Implications for Nursing Practice and Research, and the conclusion to help me decide if I want to save this article or keep looking. Other databases may look different, and it might take some trial and error to find how to search and limit your results. Most databases still offer the option to save or download the article in some type of citation assistance. For this assignment, you may also want to find national benchmark data. This is where your online resource evaluation skills come into play. Typically, websites that end in .edu and .gov are considered reliable sources. Websites that will need further evaluation to determine credibility include those that end in .com, .net, and .org. How do I determine if a website is a credible source? Ask yourself the following questions. Is the site published by a well-known company, business, or institution? Is there an author? Can you search for the author and find their credentials? Is there a copyright date or larger, more well-known name associated with the page? Are there references and citations included? Is there a date indicating when the information was last updated or reviewed? Are there ads on the page? Ads may indicate that the page is not a credible resource because the person who posted the content had to advertise ad space to help pay for their page, but this is not always the case. Magazines and newspapers are considered credible sources, and they also contain ads. Take a closer look at the author and the content. Does this look like a professional piece backed up by research and evidence, or personal opinion and commentary? Is it a blog, which is like a personal diary published online? Wikipedia often has correct information, but this site is not considered a credible source. This is because anyone can go on this site and edit the information. What are the intentions of this site? Are they sharing educational information? Are they expressing an opinion? Are they trying to sell something or get donations? This may seem intimidating, but use your best judgment. You are probably already better at recognizing reliable, trustworthy information on the internet than you may think. Another important resource accessible from the library homepage are the library research guides. You can browse a list of the guides by subject, or you can look through a complete list of research guides. You can also search all guides at the same time in the search bar. The results will show where your search terms appear in all of our LibGuides. The Nursing Research Guide has all of the resources you need in one convenient place. You can search the library catalog, search the nursing databases, view recommended credible websites, find more information about evidence-based practice resources, find resources on citations, including APA format, and find information for contacting a librarian. You can also find librarian contact information on the Nursing Research Guide homepage and schedule a virtual research consultation. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me for assistance.